have a relook at this, color code it, okay, color code it, and then reinterpret what we understood a little while back. Watch carefully. On the outside, this color code has no meaning whatsoever. It's just random colors. Okay. Yet, it brings some sense into the system. Now, this is the U-shaped heart tube, which I told you first. And this is what is going on in the cardiogenic area. Then, this is the one I am now highlighting. This is the one I'm going to talk about. You can see the arterial end and the venous end of the cardiac tube. This is a linear cardiac tube. We have discussed the details in the previous slide. Next, watch the same thing, shall I say, in an anteroposterior view. I repeat, in an anteroposterior view. See, it is the difference in the view that makes the understanding different from the previous slides. Now, you see, as the looping takes place, watch carefully what I'm saying. This one, what I'm highlighting here, this is the sinus venosus. I repeat, sinus venosus. The sinus venosus, as shown in the previous slide, was behind the arterial end. That is why the rest of the sinus venosus is missing from you in this diagram, because this is an anteroposterior diagram. Next, other than the sinus venosus, it is the atrium that you saw in the posterior part of the previous slide. If you want, for a moment, we will go back to the previous slide. You see, atrium is behind, sinus venosus is in the posterior part. In the anterior part, here is the aortic and the pulmonary, that is the arterial end. Now, recalling that into this particular next slide, you see, therefore, when you see the same thing in front view, the atrium very little can be seen, or sometimes not at all, depending upon the view, and very little of the sinus venosus is seen. That is what I'm showing in. But what can be best seen, you see, I repeat, then what is best seen is the entire ventricle and the bulbous cordis and its derivatives. You see, the bulbo ventricular lobe is best seen in anterior view because that is the presenting structure. Okay, the sinus venosus and the atrium are behind it, therefore you see very little of it. I hope you understood this part of the slide, this one. Necessary, I will read.
Yes.
Now, having understood this, let's move to the next one, this one.
So, can you please repeat that?
This one.
Yes, sir.
Now, this slide, this particular, whatever both the thing that you are seeing here, is nothing but the same that you saw here. This is lateral view. Okay, when you see the same from here in this direction, you will get, I repeat, in this direction, you will get the view as seen here. So in this, what happened, you are looking from front, therefore the ventricles completely, both the future ventricles and the conus part, you know, the bulbous cordis part, will be best seen. Therefore, as it develops, the ventricle, this and this are the bulbous cordis derivatives, are prominently seen from front. What is not seen or very little seen is a small atrium, but in the next few days, the atrium starts to enlarge. You see, the atrium starts to enlarge, because right now it is single atrium. It is not right atrium, it is not left atrium. So also the ventricle, although labeled here as right ventricle, left ventricle, it is still a single cavity inside. Now what happens? Because of the expansion of the atrium, there is no place for the atrium to come forward. So what happens? It wraps itself around the aortic contents, around the aorta and the pulmonary artery. And this is the future final shape of the heart. I repeat, this is the future final shape. This is the basis, embryological basis of the final shape of the heart. That is why That is why, let's go back to the previous slide, then you will understand what I'm talking. Okay. Now you see, this is the right ventricle. This is the left ventricle. Hardly anything is seen of the left atrium. This part is the right atrium. The reason why, in a front view, in an adult heart from the dead body, the right atrium and left atrium, hardly anything is visible, because it is overrided. That means it is taken over by this part, that is the future bulbous cordis. What do you mean by the future bulbous cordis? The subvalvular part of the conus arteriosus that gives rise to the infundibulum and the immediate part of the aorta, subvalvular regions of the aorta and the pulmonary trunk. Clear? This is the understanding. Now that's the importance of the cardiac loop. I think it's time to give you a pause, but I'm not going to go take 5 minutes off. I want you to, you know, get this filtered into your brains. This takes time, but I'm willing to wait patiently, if necessary, re-explain, because if you don't understand this, the rest of the thing will be virtually Greek and Latin. If you want any explanation, this is the time to ask. Yeah. Okay. If you don't have any questions to ask, yeah.
So you look at this this 28 days picture. This right atrium and right ventricle, there is like, you know, there is a gap. So how it gets fused in a 50 days?
This slide I have not yet explained, but I'm happy that you are curious to know the details. I appreciate that.
So I right didn't get this.
Yeah, let me explain that. See, right now, don't worry about the days. It is a process that is more important. It is not the timeline. So for your batch, for your course, I am keeping the timeline and the related discussion out of context. It doesn't make any sense. Somewhere between third week and fourth week, you see. Now, this slide differs from the previous slide. Let me slowly move you forwards. This slide differs from the previous slide in the sense it is the same previous slide, absolutely the same slide, except the cavities are visible. You see, the cavity is visible. You got my point?
Yes.
The lumen is visible. See, if you slice through the tube, you can see the interior. The previous one was the exterior view of the developing heart. All along, I have been presenting to you the exterior view of the developing heart tube without confusing you into the interior details. You see, now it's like the house is built, the interior decorators have taken over. You see, once interior decoration is started, it goes chaotic, isn't it? It's like your family, daughter wants this, mother wants that, father wants this, isn't it? So it's a family of four individuals, right atrium, left atrium. Similarly, the right ventricle and left. What do you do when you build a new house? You go and say, this is my room, this is your room. Father says, all of you have your own rooms, I will stay in the kitchen. Things like that, same story here also. It is just an example to make you understand, that's all. Now let's look at this in detail. There's nothing particular to talk to you about the 15-day embryo. Okay, the arterial end, sorry, the atrium, the ventricle and the CT is clearly indicated. Now you can see at the 21-day embryo seems to be a little better way of understanding, because you seem to already have some kind of a orientation to this photograph. The same shape you have seen previously, only thing is that shape did not have the cavity shown. Now the same it is, with the cavity. You can see how the same items are getting realigned. Okay, are getting realigned. Now, at 28th day, I repeat, this third one, this one, this area I'm now going to talk of, is actually next stage development. You are beginning to understand this is the arterial end of the loop. This is the venous end of the loop. That means this is the area where sinus venosus is located. This is the area where the conus arteriosus and its derivatives are located. By the word conus arteriosus, I mean two things, the aorta and the pulmonary trunk. So all the arterial derivatives are here and all the venous derivatives are at the back. When they come together, that's the U-shaped loop which I was talking about. This is the U-shape. Only thing is the two ends of the loop have come together. Okay. I'll take a pause. I'm sure there is some confusion still. If so, tell me what exactly is the confusion. All that you have to remember is, it's the same previous line. Only thing is the cavities are now beginning to show. Now the cavities are beginning to show because it's time partitions are built into the house. Now those are the walls slowly developing. Like for example, watch this carefully. Let me see if I can remove the you see, there's a way of removing all the things. Now, each one is occupying their respective rooms. Watch carefully. This is initially one single atrium. You see, this is single atrium. Now, you can see that a central septum is beginning to develop. Can you see?
Yeah. Yes.
Therefore, there's one daughter and one son. Daughter takes one room. The son takes the other room. Okay. Similarly, there is a single ventricle. You see, there is a single ventricle, and that gets a septum or a wall that divides it into a future right ventricle and a left ventricle. Clear?
Yeah.
Therefore, it's time to label these as interatrial septum. You see, atrial septum and
interventricular
septum.
Okay.
Next, once you build a house for putting your clothes for drying, you go to the terrace, isn't it? Yes or no? I mean,
yes.
Just more a joke, but then it helps you understand the point. So what the diary does? To help you go there, he doesn't put a ladder, he puts a spiral staircase, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, may not be spiral, it may be, but the point is the concept. You see, you put a spiral staircase to reach the terrace. Same story here also. A spiral septum, I repeat, a spiral septum comes up here to divide this area into two parts, an aortic part and a pulmonary part. You see?
Okay.
The only difference is that is the only septum which is spiral. The other walls are all straight. Because that is the only one that takes you to the terrace. By the word terrace, I mean here it is one way towards the pulmonary trunk into the lung, the other one through the aorta into the systemic circulation. Generally, by the word systemic circulation, we mean the terrace. That's all. Now this is in essence the trends in the development of the heart. Once everything is in place, the interior decorations are all over, this will be the final shape of the heart. You see, you have the right atrium, you have the left atrium, And watch carefully here, that is the interatrial septum. Details of which we will take up shortly. Similarly, this is the right ventricle. Here is the left ventricle. And this one is the interventricular septum. Then you do all the fittings, isn't it? After everything is over, you bring the sink, you bring all those things. Same story here also. Between the right atrium and the right ventricle, you fit the tricuspid valve. The plumber will come, he will fit the tricuspid valve. Similarly, another plumber will come, he will fit the mitral valve this side and go away. Now, for reasons of curiosity, you see, he started with a pair of very, very simple endothelial tubes and call them the primitive heart tubes, right and left primitive heart tubes. In just a matter of 4 weeks, we already seem to have a draft plan of the shape of the heart. We seem to have a draft plan of the future shape of the adult heart. It is at this stage, I repeat, it is at this stage, watch carefully what I am saying. The muscle component develops around the endothelium. This muscle component is a mesodermal derivative from the, you know, the intraembryonic mesoderm in the vicinity of this area contributes to the muscle development. Now that area, the which contributes to muscle, is known as the myoepicardial mantle. Myoepicardial mantle. From there, the heart muscle mass is developed, right? If you are with me, I will move cautiously to the left next slide with the assurance that if there is any difficulty in understanding, I will go slow.